Okay. Hi, Venkatesh. Good morning. How are you doing?
Hey, Seema. Very good morning. I'm great. How are you?
I'm also good. And thanks for asking. And thanks for taking time to introduce your talk, which you are going to present in Regional Scrum Gathering Hyderabad, India 2019 on 29th and 30th March. And for the viewers, right now I'm with Venkatesh Rajamani, who is going to present a workshop on liberating structures, which is like a toolbox to engage everyone in the group. So let's start with a brief introduction of Venkatesh. Yes, Venkatesh.
Hey, thank you, Seema, for the quick introduction about the gathering. My name is Venkatesh Rajamani. As most of you know, I'm a professional Scrum trainer with Scrum.org and a certified Scrum coach with Scrum Alliance. I've been training people, I would say training and coaching people for about 5 years now. As a generalization, I would say the profession of software development can definitely be improved by improving the collaboration, and the power of collaboration and intelligence of people are going to be the fuel of improving the profession. So I'm excited, and I'm going to share some of my experiences in the Regional Scrum Gathering on how do we unleash the power of collaboration. Back to you.
Wow, wonderful. So your talk must be on some power of collaboration. And I told you that your talk is on liberating structures. So can you give a brief idea about these structures?
Yes. So I often get this question, what do you mean by liberating structure? It looks like an oxymoron for us. Structures which are liberated. Yes, you are right. We are giving a structure which is very much liberated because have you seen that when you feel included and engaged, do you do a better job, do you think?
Yes, because if I am engaged, I feel I am valued. So it creates a significant difference.
Yes, and have you also noticed some of the powerful ideas come from unknown or unexpected sources most often?
Yes, because many people are shy and they don't want to be engaged in until unless they are forced. And also force should be come from inside. So we need some tool so it can engage everyone in the group in the same manner, and at least some participation should be there.
Correct. So you're right. This is more about having a liberator structures, which is going to unleash the power and intelligence of people. Mm-hmm. And that's going to fuel innovation. So when you talk about liberating structures, you are right. It is one of the facilitation techniques, you could say. Mm-hmm. That starts with so simple and essentially that as not to seem worth doing it, but at the end you will feel the how powerful and profound it is.
Okay, so it is used as a facilitation tool. So how it is different from other traditional facilitation tools and techniques which are typically used by Scrum Masters and other leaders?
Right, so most of the facilitation techniques, if you would have observed, I'm sure, we think the innovative power is reserved with one of the experts. Mm-hmm. But the liberating structure strongly believes that the power is going to be not only in the expert's hands, but in the hands of everyone.
Okay. So when I was reading your talk proposal, I read that there are 33 structures. So to create interest in your target audience, can you give some examples of these structures?
Yes, sure. Before I give some introduction about the structures, I wanted to also talk about how we are going to introduce these structures to the audience. We are going to demonstrate one of the case studies with which we demonstrated and unleashed the power and collaboration of people when I was engaging with one of the major payment clients. Mm-hmm. So there we used these structures to bring three in a box leaders to unleash the collaboration as well as build common consensus. So you could observe that the liberating structures will introduce some tiny ships, small ships. Mm-hmm. The way that we meet, we plan, we decide and engage to each other. So a couple of examples that I wanted to give you is icebreakers, 1-2-4 all. If you want to introduce some prompts to people, when I say prompts, here we are talking about anything that is going to be an icebreaker for people, one, two, four, all. So initially, there is a self-reflection among people. Individually, they are going to come up with some responses. Then they are going to collaborate with a couple of pairs in the room. Then the structure gets extended to four, all. So finally, the entire group is going to build some consensus on what they thought and how the group is reacting to that. So that is one. Some other structures, for example, Trokia Consulting. So we strongly believe we have the entire intelligence and power in this room, and how we bring engagement level from everybody. So Trokia Consulting is going to give some of the solutions from individuals. So we think that the solutions can be incrementally built from the group by unleashing their power again.
Wow, wonderful. I'm sure it is going to be exciting because I am getting my experience when I joined Landmark Forum, and some kind of 1-to-4 structure I have used when I was, I spent my time to think myself for self-reflection, and then I converse with my buddy in form of storytelling, and then 4 or 5 people got involved, and then we collaborated in a whole group. And I was thinking that there are 200 people in room, and how they are creating a structure where everyone is involved, everyone's concern is taken care, and everybody is going to share, and everybody has shared their stories. That's wonderful. So I'm sure that your all the structures are going to be wonderful, and it will create excitement in all leaders and Scrum Masters. So my next question is that when I talk about facilitation, automatically Scrum Master role comes in my mind. Who is your target audience?
So yes, you are right, because we think Scrum Masters are enablers, then doers. They facilitate events as needed, and they ensure that the collaboration is good enough in the room. But for this Liberating Structures immersion, anybody who wanted to unleash the power of collaboration, they can join. We are going to demonstrate using a lot of structures. I'm sure that they can take some of these concrete practices back to work and create a distributed control rather than doing a traditional meetings. They could create a distributed controls and improve the way they conduct meetings. So audience, anyone with an open mindset who wanted to learn how Liberating Structures can help you at your work, please join.
All right. So friends, if you want to engage everyone in the group, if you want to make present everyone, and if you want to hear everyone's voice in a group setting, come and join Venkatesh Rajamani workshop in Regional Scrum Gathering Hyderabad, India 2019, which is going to happen on 29th. And thanks for watching this video. Thanks, Venkatesh, for introducing your workshop and to give a brief idea and to create an excitement for these Liberating Structures. Thank you.
Thank you, Seema, for the opportunity. See you all soon.
Yeah, sure.